Hey, why aren't you dressed yet?
I had to fix the car so it'll be ready for later, but I'm about to get dressed in a bit.
All right, then.
Your earphones. Always check your earphones, okay? If ever you need anything, we're ready to back you up.
Thank you. You know, Yvonne, don't worry about me too much. You should think about yourself.
What is it?
Nothing. So, are you ready?
Yes.
All right.
Your earphones. I hope that this time you don't slip up. Remember, Anna, this is a serious mission. You have to be on alert.
Okay, I'll keep that in mind.
I'll just go get dressed. Make sure to be ready.
Okay. Let's go.
Thank you so much for gracing the Del Mundo charity event.
And for supporting my mom's advocacy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, then. Please sit wherever you want.
You look great.
Oh, there they are.
Hi,
Stella, Xander. We're glad you could come.
Yes. Good thing I was able to convince Xander.
Why? Didn't he want to attend?
Not really. I'm just not used to going to parties like this. Right, hon?
Yeah.
Go find Hillary.
Okay. Excuse me, where's Hillary?
Oh, Mom. Oh, she's here somewhere there. There!
Okay, excuse me. I'll just go talk to her. I'll be back.
Sure.
Hillary.
Hi. Stella, how are you?
I'm good. By the way, I also donated some books and school supplies for the children.
Oh, thank you.
If you need anything else, just let me know, all right? I really do want to help those precious kids. I just want to give back after everything that happened to us and to give honor to my parents.
I know.
You know?
Stella, I already had you investigated. I finally know who you really are.
Xander.
Hmm.
You look tense.
Not at all. I'm just not used to social events like this.
Oh, really? Gatherings like these should be normal to you, right? You and Stella are rich people, aren't you? Like us.
Well, Stella's the one who's rich, not me. And again, I'm not really fond of fancy parties like this. Guys, if you'll excuse me, I'll just go find my wife.
Xander, wait. Don't worry too much about your wife. I'm sure that Aunt Hillary and her are talking about a lot of things.
Aw, why, Xander? Don't you like talking to us? Are we boring you already? You want to join the other guests instead?
It's not that. I don't even know anyone else here.
Oh. You are very wrong, Xander. Because you know someone at this party. In fact, she's looking for you.
Really? Who?
Oh, there she is.
Hi,
Escandalaria.
Sweetie.
Welcome. Mwah. Samantha del Mundo Ojeda.
Thanks for inviting me, dear.
Oh, and my husband.
Hello.
Madam, Gael Ojeda.
Lovely to meet you. Well, Xander, darling. Hey, what? Why do you look so surprised, dear? Don't you remember me? It's me, your Aunt Carlotta, a close friend of Stella's mom. You and Stella even attended my third wedding together, right? Remember? Come, darling, give me a kiss. Come on. Mwah. Mwah.
Who's that? And why is she hugging Xander?
I have no idea. They probably know each other.
You know, guys, I have a bad feeling about this. Xander looks so tense.
Of course, Aunt. I do remember. How can I forget?
Why didn't you tell me that you're back already?
Well, you see, Aunt, we didn't even know you're here. We actually thought you were still in Africa, right?
Oh, well, it's a long story, but I'll just tell you about it later. Where's Stella?
Stella, I'll just look for her, Aunt.
Hurry up! I really want to see her.
Of course, I'll
go
find
on,
her.
Dear.
Okay, excuse me, guys.
I already saw the list of your donations. Thank you very much, Stella.
She'll surely go a long way. Please sign this.
Just a minute, okay?
Right here.
Anna, can you hear me now? You have to come with me outside.
Why? Why don't you come here instead?
Anna, I can't, because if I go there right now, someone might see you. Somebody is looking for Stella. She can't find you there. You have to go outside. Hurry up.
Thank you.
Stella, you have to come with me. Someone's looking for you. I think you'd like to come, Aunt.
Xander!
Jido!
Xander, Gael is with Anna right now.
What?
Oh, Xander! Where's Stella?
I can't find her. If you want, let's look for her over there.
She's here.
All right. Who are you?
Stella. Stella Guerrero.
Stella? That's strange.
Carlotta, don't you know who Stella is?
I think I should have my glasses checked.
Oh, come on. Don't you remember Stella?
Aunt. Stella. Wait, hon.
Stupid of me. I'm really sorry, Stella. Come, give me a hug. Oh, dear. It's been a long time.
So, she really is Stella.
The one and only. I just didn't recognize her with his hair and makeup. Look at you. And also, you have to admit, you've lost so much weight, Stella. If only your mother was still alive, she'd be so glad. Because you're starting to look a lot like your mom.
Thank you, Aunt. You look as beautiful as ever.
So how are you, darling? It's been so long since I last saw you. If it weren't for Hillary, I wouldn't have known that you're finally back in town.
Well, as always, Aunt, we don't want too much attention.
Yes.
Oh, you two haven't changed at all. Well, could you excuse us for a while? I think we have a lot of catching up to do.
Of course, go ahead.
All sure. Right, thank you. Let's head over there. Come on, how have you been?
Anyway, I have to go ahead now. It's for the presentation. Excuse me.
Gael. Where are you going? Are you going to follow Stella?
Sam, I'm not convinced that they really know each other. For all we know, they could just be working together.
That Carlotta may sound crazy, but she is one of the richest women in the country. And she's been sponsoring my dad for the longest time. I don't think she would betray us.
Exactly. She might not be in the right state of mind, and she wasn't able to tell the difference between Stella and Anna.
Do you really doubt Carlotta's credibility that much? Is she really the issue here, Gael? Or you just can't accept the simple fact that Anna is not Stella?
I don't want to be fooled again, Sam. You know that.
Oh, darling, I was so worried about you. I was wondering what you have been up to these past few years because you didn't even show up at your mom and dad's funeral. Are you still angry at them, my dear?
Aunt, no. Well, I can't really blame them if they reacted that way, right?
But all I could think of was, maybe you felt so restricted by them.
But a lot has changed, Aunt.
Well, I guess maturity comes with age. But you know what? It seems like I'm the only one who keeps maturing but doesn't age.
Aunt, can I go to the restroom? I just have to fix my hair.
All right, go ahead. I'm going to get a table for us as well.
Okay.
Okay?
I'll go with her,
Aunt. With me, yes.
All right.
Thank you. Stella didn't have any relatives.
She doesn't. She's a close friend of Stella's mom. She was there when Stella was growing up, but they're not related.
But come on, Xander, that was close. You should have told me that I might run into someone who knows about Stella.
I didn't know she was coming. In fact, the last time we talked to Aunt Carlotta was when Stella and I ran away.
So you mean they have no idea that Stella is dead?
No one knows about Stella's death. Stella made me promise not to tell anyone about her death, so she can be at peace. Aunt doesn't know.
Hey, what happened in there?
Who was that, Xander? Is she Stella's relative?
How did she know that you were here? Well, from what I know is, the Del Mundos invited her to try and prove that I'm really Anna.
But why did that woman mistake Anna for Stella?
Because it's been a while since she last saw Stella. And right now, with the way Anna is made up, she does look a lot like Stella.
I want to know if the two of them were really close, because I don't know what she's talking about.
They were really close. When Stella and I eloped, out of all her relatives and friends, no one approved, but she's the only one who gave her blessing.
But wait, what do I do now? The more we talk, the more suspicious she'll get, because I really have no idea what to tell that woman.
Here's what you'll do. Just smile at her. If you don't know the answer, then try to change the topic, but what matters most now is that we all get through tonight.
Aunt Carlotta really likes talking about herself. She loves being complimented. And she just keeps going. She doesn't stop talking to people about everything she likes doing, Anna.
I hope she'd stop asking me questions because I don't know what to say.
Don't worry about it. Hang on, you can get through this.
Anna, just think about this. If we manage to convince her that you're really Stella, in a way it's like convincing the Del Mundos.
What now, Anna? Can you handle it?
As I was saying, Africa is such a magnificent continent. The wilderness is so breathtaking. But of course, life over there is not that easy. That's why I dedicated 10 years of my life helping those people. As you both know, my heart aches for the poor.
So, it has been 10 years since you lived in Africa. Meaning... it's been 10 years since you last saw him and Stella?
Darling, we used to have video calls with each other back then. As a matter of fact, I would even talk to Stella whenever her mom looks for her. But my goodness, it was a really difficult time then. I was so helpless. I was trying to convince her to go home, but what can I do? Stella and Sandra really loved each other. So I just tried to cover up what she was doing from her mom.
So... you know exactly where they were staying 10 years ago?
Well, yes? Hold on. Why do you seem so curious to know more about Stella?
Nothing in particular. It's just that... they're both so mysterious. So, I would like to know them better.
Well, if you want to know them, I should tell you that the only daughter of the Delatoris is such a kind person. Just like me. But don't try to cross her. So, I would like to say to those negative people out there, well, they should watch out.
Ma'am Hillary, excuse me.
Oh, okay, all right, thanks. Yes. Please excuse me. I'll leave you two for a bit.
Okay.
Just have to attend to something.
All
Samantha,
right.
Please take care of our guests.
Okay, Mom.
Okay.
No, I'll
Thank
see
you,
you later.
So much, Hillary.
So, Aunt? Oh, may I call you Aunt, Miss Candelaria?
I guess. Well, if you become friends with Stella.
So, Aunt.
Yes?
Do you know why Xander and Stella are suddenly back?
Well, I guess it's time. And since Stella's parents are both dead, no one will stop the two of them from loving each other.
Aunt, are you talking about the two of us?
Oh, well, I'm sorry, darling, but this girl keeps asking questions about you. She must really like you, Stella.
Well, I think so too, Aunt. I just really hope that, now that you're finally here, she can get to know me better. I'm excited for our friendship.
Alma? Where are they?
Yes, ma'am. They're over here.
When is it going to be?
I said go home. Don't make a scene.
Sir, we just need you to answer us. We're begging you, please.
Gael, what's happening here?
Aunt, I can handle this. Please go back inside.
Ma'am, we live in the community near Agham's site. We're not going
away. Excuse me, may I know what the problem is?
We just want to know, what's the status of the clinic you promised us? More people are getting sick, ma'am, and we can't afford health care.
Yes, you have to help us.
Gael, didn't I allot money for that, so you could start building the clinic? Then why haven't you begun the construction yet?
Well, it was hard work. First, we had to set up the solar panels, which will provide electricity to their community. Goodness, to think that they didn't have access to clean water. I'm so grateful we have a friend who knows how to dig underground for fresh water. Oh, darling, you wouldn't believe it. I helped them dig the ground. We built a well in their community. You should have seen their faces when they saw the fresh, clean water. Oh, it was very touching.
You're incredible, Aunt. You still haven't changed. Your life is still full of adventures.
True! You know me, I don't like staying in one place. I want excitement. I want thrill. Now that I think of it, maybe that's the reason why no one wanted to be my fourth husband. All of my ex-husbands left me. That's why you shouldn't let this good man go. You know that him and I are very much alike. We're free spirits. He might end up leaving you.
No, Aunt, that's never going to happen. Because on the day she chose me, I promised her that I'll stay forever.
Aww. Love, love, love. I really miss the feeling of being in love. If only Julio saw how much the two of you really loved each other, maybe he could have changed his mind.
Aunt, I think it would be much better if we don't talk about the past.
But, darling, you and your mother have already forgiven each other, right? Because that's what she told me the last time we talked. What really happened between you and your mom?
Aunt, maybe it would be much better not to talk about this issue here.
Oh.
Oh. Why not? I want to know more about your family.
Excuse me, my dear. Don't you think it's a little bit personal? And it's a family matter. So I hope you won't mind, and you'll understand if we ask you to excuse us for a while and to give us a little bit of space?
Of course. I have other things to do anyway. Excuse me.
Yes, thank you.
and I had to transfer the funds. I had to use the money for other purposes because our gold bars were stolen.
At the expense of the miners, as well as their families?
Aunt, I'm just doing my job. Isn't this what you wanted?
Please, ma'am.
Mister, I'll take care of this. I would just like to ask for some more time.
Darling, I'm sorry. I got so carried away. But it's good to know that you really still love your parents, huh? All this time, I thought you carried a grudge when they died.
No, Aunt. I think we should just let my parents rest in peace.
Oh, does that mean you'll be taking over the hospital from now on?
And what do you mean?
Oh, well, because, darling, I have been overseeing the operations of the hospital business of your family for 10 years now. I'm so exhausted, my dear. Maybe now is the perfect time for you to take over. It's your business.
Well, Aunt, Stella can't take over the hospital business anymore because the money she inherited from her parents were all donated to charity.
5 kids have been killed in our town because of your company's negligence! These deaths have to stop right now!
I will personally make sure this problem will be solved. Just trust me on this. I promise I'll fix this.
You're a bunch of liars! You've said that before!
What? You've got some nerve! You have to leave now!
You must make promises!
We need to have the clinic!
Let go of me!
Get them out of here.
My daughter is dying!
She could be my proxy. She could attend meetings on my behalf. At least I get to rest even for just a bit. I'm sure she'll do her best. Since, after all, it's her business.
Aunt, maybe now is not the time. I really can't do it.
Okay. Come here. I just want you to know that no matter what, I'm always here for you, okay? If you need anything, just let your aunt know, all right?
Thank you.
Okay.
Hey, Anna, are you done yet? Hillary is on her way out.
Aunt, excuse me, I need to handle something.
Oh, sure. Huh?
Go ahead.
Where is she now?
They're outside. What are you doing anyway? What took you so long?
Stella's aunt was talking to me.
Oh, so you've forgotten about our mission. She's right outside. Talk to her while you still can.
Okay.
No, please, you can't
Hillary.
Do this!
Hillary!
You have to listen to us!
There's too many out of here!
Stella!
Oh my god!
I rushed that guy!
I'm not scared!
Are you okay?
That just proves you're all monsters! We're nothing to you! I'll be arrested!
Stella, please don't get involved.
No. Mister, what seems to be the problem here? Why do you have to hurt people?
Ma'am, they just keep making promises to us.
That's right.
They only think about themselves.
That's right.
That's right.
So what is it you want from them?
We need a clinic for our community. Our lives are put in danger every single day. And it's not even our fault. Ma'am, please have mercy on our children.
Mister, didn't I tell you already? I'm going to do everything that I can.
You expect us to believe that? Because we don't want to listen to your lies anymore!
Mister, let's make a deal. My name is Stella Guerrero. Keep that in mind. I will help your community.
Can we count on you, ma'am?
Yes. Because unlike others out there, I do know how to stay true to my word and keep my promises. So could you please trust me on this?
All right, ma'am. Thank you,
ma'am.
You'll look forward
to
that.
Is she really going to help us?
Yvonne, where's Anna?
She's outside. Go after her.
Stella? Stella! What happened?
It's nothing. Don't worry.
Stella! What happened?
Oh, my.
Stella? Stella, what happened? Stella!
Hurry up, Stella.
Take her to the clinic. Stella, what happened to her?
Thank you. You're welcome.
I'm glad it's not serious.
I'm all right.
Anna, we both agreed. You need to earn Hillary's trust. but it's not about putting yourself in harm's way to protect them.
I do know that, but I guess I just couldn't help it.
If you do that, we're not going to succeed. Keep in mind, you can't have mercy on your enemies. Remember that. We're doing this mission to take them down.
Xander! Were you just reprimanding Stella?
No, Aunt. I was just worried about her, that's all.
Oh, darling, what happened? Good thing you didn't get hit on your beautiful face. Don't worry, I have a doctor who can help you with this.
Stella, how are you?
I'm okay, I'm okay.
Wait, I just want to thank
her. Oh, go ahead.
Thank you so much. You didn't have to do that. You didn't have to save me.
Oh, it's nothing. I did that because they're counting on you. That miner needs your help, Hillary, as well as the other people.
Aww, that's Stella for you. A beautiful woman with a big heart who's always ready to help everyone in need.
Hillary, I really hope you can fix their problem.
Oh, we will work it out. I will talk to Gael and I'll take care of what he needs for the project.
I know, you did the right thing. You really do have a big heart. You want to help people and you understand what I feel.
You don't know how thankful I am for your trust, Stella.
We're sorry, sir. We didn't expect things would get out of hand.
How can you not anticipate it? It's your job, right? If you asked those rude protesters to leave the place, it wouldn't have resulted to this.
Really sorry, sir.
And what can your apology do to the injured guest earlier, huh? My mother-in-law, she almost got hit with a rock. Now get out! You're fired! Listen, the four of you better do your job this time.
Yes, sir.
And tighten the security at the mine.
Thank you so much for coming. I'll see you in the next event. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Here's my card. Call me anytime, darling.
Sure.
Okay? Aunt. Hope to hear from you.
Okay.
Come on. Hillary, darling.
Hi.
Lovely party.
Thank you for coming on such short notice.
Thank you for inviting me.
Miss Candelaria, thank you so much.
Mwah. Okay? You. I'll see you both. Call me, okay?
Yes, Aunt. Take care.
Bye.
Bye. Stella, I really owe you. I owe you one. Let's both have dinner sometime, okay?
Yes.
And I hope your wound would heal soon. Thank you once again for coming and for being here, Xander. Thank you so much.
It's nothing. Thank you also for inviting us.
Anytime. Until the next?
Yes, we'll go ahead.
Okay.
Bye.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye, Miss
Hillary.
Samantha.
Stella?
Thank you.
Samantha. Mr. Guerrero.
Yeah, we'll be on our way, ma'am.
Hi, Bye. Hello.
Are you okay? You look tired right now.
Well, who wouldn't be exhausted? I spent all night talking to your Aunt Carlotta. I almost ran out of things to say.
But you still managed to save Hillary.
What?
Nothing. Let's go.
Don't you think that Mrs. Guerrero's timing was suspiciously perfect? She saved your mom at the right time.
She came right on time, if you ask me. It's as if she set it all up so she'd look like a hero.
Oh, why Miss Samantha? What do you mean by that? She planned all this? But what for?
I don't know. To try to get close to mom?
Oh, no. First it was your husband, and now she's after your mom? What is that woman planning to do?
I don't care what she's planning to do. But if I were her, she better stay away from my family. Because I'm not planning on sharing them with that woman.
Let's meet up. I have to see Anna's family soon.
Didn't I tell you to always put your safety first and foremost? Hold this.
I'm sorry, Missy. I couldn't help it at the time.
Anna, I know it's natural for you to be kind, so I really can't blame you. But be mindful. Please think about what could happen to you before you put yourself in harm's way. Anna, your life is very important. I'm all right. Don't worry. And thank goodness for Stella.
Yes, Samantha told me about that. I can't believe it. Who knew she'd do that to you? You're not even related to her. I'm sure she wants something in return.
I don't think so. Because I was able to talk to her after the paramedics attended to her wound. Salvador, all she really wants is for us to build the clinic we promised to those people.
Does Gael know?
He does, but he hasn't even started with it. Because right now he's more focused on retrieving the stolen gold.
Then I think we should follow Gael's lead because he knows how the mine operates, right?
Hold on, Salvador. Who is the owner of that company? Isn't it me? I think it's fair to say that I could handle simple decisions regarding the hospital.
Yes. Okay, right? All right. I know you're tired, so let's decide later on. We'll talk about it, okay? Go get some rest.
Okay. And can you please stop investigating about Stella? I don't think she has ulterior motives. The wound is not that serious. Luckily for you, it's not too deep.
Anna, how are you? Are you dizzy or do you feel nauseous?
I'm doing fine. I just feel lightheaded. What were you thinking, Anna? You didn't have to protect any one of the Del Mundos from getting hurt. I didn't expect that.
I was surprised by what you did too. But can you please make sure that you listen to me, see?
You know what? You really don't need to worry about me. I'll take care of myself.
How can I not worry about you? You're so important to us. You're one of us. So whether you like it or not, we're always going to worry about you.
Thank you.
I already did what you asked. I told our men to track down the man who tried to harass your wife, Hillary.
Well, that's good, but you know what you're going to do next.
Do we have to? Nothing bad happened to Hillary.
Well, should I wait for something bad to happen to my wife? I want everyone to know that no one can hurt anyone in my family.
No matter what we say or do, Salvador, the poor people from the community will still blame Hillary's company. That man was protesting because Hillary didn't fix the problem about the clinic.
Look, I'm just protecting Hillary from this mess. Gael as well, but he's the one in charge of Agham. I don't want his reputation to be ruined because he is going to run in the coming elections.
Well, if that's what you want, then why don't we just help the miners?
But how? Are you going to build a clinic for them like Hillary?
We'll support Hillary's project. They'll think we're helping them, when in fact, they're actually doing us a favor. This project is a great opportunity for you to vastly improve your reputation. This way you can introduce Gael to the people and actually gain more votes.
Sir, so did you find them?
It wasn't easy, sir. Because not a lot of people know them. But I managed to find a way. Here. You're currently living in that address.
Dandan, open the door.
Grandma, maybe Emmy came to visit us.
Dandan.
What are you doing here?
Dandan, I didn't come here to cause trouble. Dandan!
Go away!
Dandan! I'm not here to cause trouble, okay?
Leave us alone. You're not welcome here.
Grandma Puring, I just want to talk to you.
Just like your wife wanted to talk to us too?
Samantha?
Yes, we met up, and then we talked.
We already moved, and now you're following us?
If you're still looking for my granddaughter, why don't you just talk to your wife? Because we've told her everything about my granddaughter.
get out of here and stop wasting our time.
Even if I tell you that I know where you can find Anne? Because I know where she is. So if you want to see her, you have to come with me.
Get out of here.
Grandma, don't you want to see your granddaughter?
You managed to fool us before. What makes you think we're going to trust you? Leave now, or I'm going to call the police.
Dandan, my offer is not going to change. When you're ready to see your sister, give me a call.
You're slow today. Haven't you been training properly?
Let's just say I'm going easy on you. I won't make it difficult. I'm going to use one hand.
You don't have to do that for me. I'm not like Anna. I can handle it.
Anna can take care of herself too.
Oh, really? Well, wasn't she tricked by the Del Mundos?
The Del Mundos might have tricked her, but it doesn't make her a weak person. And she's just doing her job.
What? Pretending to be your wife? Why, does she really look like Stella?
Yes. That's what the mission needs. And she's doing a good job at it.
At being a good wife to you, or what?
Why don't you just go straight to the point?
Well, I just want to know if we can really trust that woman.
Anna's smart. I know that she can be trusted. And I will say it again. We need her for this mission. So now, do you have questions?
No, I don't.
So you're going somewhere. You didn't even tell me.
Don't even start with this, Samantha. I'm not in the mood.
When are we going to talk about this? Are you going to come home late every night? Why don't you just tell me your schedule, Gael? What are you hiding anyway?
Am I the only one hiding something, Samantha?
What are you talking about? What? Are you still trying to look for Anna? I thought you were going to stop.
Well, it turns out that I'm not the only one looking for Anna, right? I went over there and they told me that you already talked to them and you were looking for Anna.
Well then, so what if I did? I just want to end your obsession with that woman.
You're the one who's obsessed, Sam! You talk about trust, but you don't even trust me at all! You're the one moving behind my back! And remember, Sam, you're pregnant! What if this search for Anna puts you in danger?
You know what? I find it hard to do what you want because you won't even offer me the same courtesy. Ouch!
I'm not kidding around with you, Samantha. If you don't want me to lose my trust in you, then don't ever do this again. You understand?
You don't have the right to control me.
Well,
or what
I do, because you're carrying my baby. And if something bad happens to our baby, I will never forgive you.
Many people are saying that the reason you're doing all of this is because you want to hide the anomalies happening at Aga Mining, a company that is owned by your wife. Any thoughts?
I don't get involved with anything regarding my wife's business. I do not have any idea about what's happening there.
Because I have my priorities as a senator. I have to focus on what I have to do. And ever since the beginning, well, I have been more focused on helping our community. I want to further develop our local community.
A lot of our countrymen are poor. And maybe, well, it's definitely because of the lack of funds for it.
But for my project, I'm going to do everything I can to help the people of San Sebastian. To my countrymen, I hope that you can help me
fulfill my projects and any kind of donation. Any kind of assistance to show your support will be much appreciated. And we'll forever be grateful for your generosity.
This is our opportunity to get close to Salvador.
Isn't Anna doing the right thing, Miss C? Isn't that enough?
No, it's not enough. If I want to get inside the circle of Salvador, I have to be more than a friend. I have to be useful to them. And it's the only way for them to fully trust me.
What are we going to do next? Are we going to donate money again?
This is the perfect chance for us to make a move and try to get close to Salvador. That's why we need to set up a business so we can have a direct link and be involved with them.
But what kind of business, though? Besides, do we even have knowledge about running one? Where can we get the funds? Do we still have enough gold for a business?
I can't say. I mean, we're spending so much money just to help Anna, and it's so hard to budget. What's more for a business?
I know, so what should we do? This is our opportunity to get close to their family. Are we really going to pass it up?
I know someone who can help us.
Approved. Take that to the showroom. Approved for production. And you, Grasha, leave. I don't want to see your face.
Miss Samantha, are you having a very bad day? Did I do something wrong? I mean, their presentation went so smoothly because I did my job properly.
Grasha, you think I care? The world does not revolve around you, okay? You are not the center of the universe. I am.
Exactly, Miss Samantha. So, what do you need? Maybe you need a helping hand, a shoulder to cry on, a sounding board, or a friend?
A friend? Don't be crazy.
What is it, Miss Samantha? I can do anything for you. Maybe you need me to help you with something?
It's because of Gael. He's still obsessing over Stella. And he's wasting time trying to prove that that girl is Anna.
Come on, Miss Samantha. Do you believe that she's Anna?
Anna, do you remember the business Aunt Carlotta was talking about? Maybe we can use that.
Hold on, Sander. No. We can't do that. We can't involve somebody else in our operation.
Miss C, she's not going to be part of our mission. All we need from her is her advice on the business.
What business is it?
Well, Stella was trying to establish a few community clinics with their own emergency equipment and mobile clinics. What Stella wanted was for the doctors to go to the people themselves.
And what happened to her plans?
I don't know. From what I heard, Aunt Carlotta took over the business afterwards. If she has experience running that business, then maybe she can help us set up something of that kind. We can hire her as a consultant. That way we can learn about how to operate it.
Well, there you have it. Why don't you talk to her?
There you go again, Chito. Don't make rash decisions. Carlotta is Stella's aunt. She might blow her cover. Those two are very close.
We can put up a business from scratch. That's the answer. We can't pass this
up. Just wait a minute. We'll let Anna decide. Well, Anna, do you think we can pull this off?
All right, let's do this. Xander, let's go see Aunt Carlotta. I have enough information to believe that she is not Anna.
Well, there you go, Miss Samantha. Why are you still worried about Stella if you believe that woman's not Anna?
For the simple reason that she looks like Anna. So as long as they share the same face, Gael won't stop thinking about her.
Oh my. That is dangerous indeed. If they do look alike, he might end up developing feelings for Stella.
That's why I have to shoo that girl away. So my husband can stop this nonsense once and for all.
But how are you going to do that, Miss Samantha?
You mean how are you going to do that, Grasha?
Who, me?
Yes, you. I want you to research about Stella Guerrero. I want to know her hobbies and her interests. I want to know more about my enemy.